Hello friends, in the last lecture we have learned definition of Laplace transform and sufficient condition for existence of Laplace transform. In that we have learned that the continuity of the function is not necessary for existence of the Laplace transform. Now today we are going to learn some example based on the definition of Laplace transform. So before that we should learn the generalized rule of integration by parts. So this formula is very important for integration. So let us see generalized rule of integration by parts. If u and v are two functions where dashes denote the derivatives and suffixes denote the integrals, then integration of u into v dx equal to u v1 minus u dash v2 plus u double dash v3 minus u triple dash v4 plus so on. So here alternate sign will be here, and dashes denote the derivative of the function u and suffixes denote the integration of the function v. So before applying this formula, we first arrange the given function in Liet form. What is the Liet form? L stands for logarithmic function, I stands for inverse function, A stands for algebraic function, T stands for trigonometric function, and E stands for exponential function. So before applying this formula, we must arrange the function in terms of Liet. Now let us begin the example. Example number 1, find the Laplace transform of the function f of t, where f of t equal to t for the limit 0 to 3 and f of t equal to 6 for t is greater than 3. Let us do the solution of this. Using definition of Laplace transform, L of f of t equal to integral of limit 0 to infinity e raised to minus st f of t dt. So this is the simple definition of Laplace transform. Now we will break this integral into two parts. Why? Because we have the function in two parts. So we must break this integral into two parts. So first integral is integral of limit 0 to 3 e raised to minus st f of t. F of t is, instead of f of t, we put t and dt, plus integral of limit 3 to infinity e raised to minus st f of t. Instead of f of t, we put in 6 and dt. Now before applying the integration, we must arrange this function in terms of Liet. So we arrange this function in terms of Liet. So what is the Liet? Here algebraic function come first and exponential function come later. So we must interchange the function. So t act as a u and exponential function e raised to minus st act as a v and dt, plus I am taking 6 as a constant. So there is no two functions, only single function is here. So, and 6 is a constant. So we take 6 as a outside. So integration of limit 3 to infinity e raised to minus st dt. Now evaluate the first integral by using integration by part. So evaluate this. So u t is a u and e raised to minus st is a v. So first t, that is u, into integration of v e raised to minus st divided by coefficient of exponential. Coefficient of exponential is minus s, so comes on the denominator, and minus derivative of u, that is t, derivative of t is 1, and we take integration of this part again. So integration of e raised to minus st by minus s is e raised to minus st divided by s square. Why is this s square? Because minus s is already there, and again coefficient of e raised to minus st is comes here. So minus s into minus s, that is plus s square. So minus sign is already here, there is no effect on that. And provide the limit 0 to 3, plus evaluate this function. So we have integration of this e raised to minus st divided by minus s, coefficient of e raised to minus st, and provide the limit 3 to infinity, and this equal to provide the limit, upper limit is 3, so minus 3 e raised to minus s, instead of t we putting 3 divided by s, minus e raised to minus 3s divided by s square. So this is the upper limit function minus lower limit. Instead of t we putting 0, e raised to minus s 0 divided by minus s, again minus e raised to minus s, instead of t we putting 0 by s square. And the next part plus 6 upper limit e raised to minus s into infinity divided by minus s, plus, see here minus sign is already here, then minus minus plus e raised to minus s 3 divided by s. This is the lower limit. Now simplify this. So this equal to minus 3 e raised to minus 3s divided by s, minus e raised to minus 3s divided by s square. First part, that is upper limit minus lower limit. So lower limit, anything multiplied by 0 is 0, minus e raised to 0 by s square. So this is the first part, and plus second part, 6 into e raised to minus infinity by s, plus e raised to minus 3s by s. Now we again simplify this. So this equal to minus 3 e raised to minus 3s by s, minus e raised to minus 3s by s square, and plus, see here e raised to 0 is 1, multiply by minus sign, so this will be plus 1 by s square. So here we get 1 by s square, plus 1 by s square, and plus the second part, e raised to minus infinity will be 0, and plus e raised to minus 3s by s. Since e raised to 0 is 1, and e raised to minus infinity equal to 1 upon e raised to infinity, but e raised to infinity is infinity, so this equal to 1 upon infinity, but 1 upon infinity is equal to 0. So because of that, we get here e raised to minus infinity is 0, and e raised to 0 is 1 here. And this equal to minus e raised to minus 3s by s, minus e raised to minus 3s by s square, and plus 1 upon s square. That is the first part, and plus 6 e raised to minus 3s by s. Now plus 6 into e raised to minus 3s by s, and minus 3 into e raised to minus 3s by s become 3 e raised to minus 3s by s, and minus e raised to 3s by s square, and plus 1 upon s square. Now exponential e raised to minus 3s and e raised to minus 3s is common in the both the term, so we taking e raised to minus 3s as a common. So this equal to 3 by s minus 1 upon s square into e raised to minus 3s plus 1 upon s square. So this is the required Laplace transform of the given function. Now come to the example number 2. Find the Laplace transform of the function f of t, where f of t is defined by like this: t minus 1 the whole square for t is greater than 1 and otherwise 0 for t running from 0 to 1. By using definition of Laplace transform, we have to find the Laplace transform of this function by using the definition of the Laplace transform. So let's begin the solution. Using definition of Laplace transform. So first of all, we will write the definition of Laplace transform. L of f of t equal to integration of limit 0 to infinity e raised to minus st f of t dt. Now again we will break the given integral into two parts. So because we have the function in terms of two parts, so first limit is integration of limit 0 to 1 e raised to minus st. So integration of limit 0 to 1, limit running from 0 to 1 has the function 0. So instead of f putting 0 and dt, plus limit running from 1 to infinity has the function t minus 1 square dt. So we substituting the function instead of f of t, but anything multiplied by the 0 will be 0, and plus integration of limit 1 to infinity e raised to minus s t into t minus 1 the whole square dt. And before integrating this function, we must arrange the function in terms of lead. So here algebraic function come first and exponential function come later. So this integral equal to integration of limit 1 to infinity t minus 1 the whole square into e raised to minus st dt. So we arrange the integral in terms of lead form. So now this is u and this is v. Now integrate by using integration by parts. So this equal to u, that is t minus 1 the whole square, and integration of v e raised to minus st divided by coefficient of exponential, that is minus s, and minus derivative of the function t minus 1 the whole square, that is 2 into t minus 1, and integration of this one, that is e raised to minus st divided by s square, and plus derivative of this, that is 2 into integration of this, that is e raised to minus st divided by minus s q. Now provide the limit 1 to infinity, and this equal to apply the upper limit. Instead of t, we putting infinity, infinity minus 1 the whole square e raised to minus infinity. So instead of t, multiply by infinity. So this become e raised to minus infinity by s minus 2. Instead of t, we putting infinity. So infinity minus 1 into e raised to minus infinity. So anything multiply by infinity, that will come infinity. So e raised to minus infinity is there. Divide by s square minus 2. So instead of again t, we putting infinity. So this become e raised to minus infinity by s q. So this is the upper limit minus lower limit. So instead of t, we putting lower limit 1. So 1 minus 1 the whole square e raised to minus s. So instead of t, we putting 1. So s multiplied by 1, that is minus. Minus s multiplied by 1, that is minus s by minus s. Minus 2, 1 minus 1 into e raised to minus s. Instead of t, we putting 1 and divide by s square. And minus 2 e raised to minus s. So instead of t, we putting 1. So this become e raised to minus s by s q. So this is the lower term. Now simplify this. See here, e raised to minus infinity. So e raised to minus infinity is 0, as we have seen in the last problem. So anything multiply by 0 become 0. So first term will be 0. Again same thing, anything multiply by 0 again become 0. The second term is also 0, and minus third term. So anything multiply by 0 again become 0. So upper limit, the whole thing will be 0. Now come to the lower limit. So minus lower limit, we simplifying 1 minus 1, that is 0. So 0 multiply by this function again become 0. So minus 1 minus 1, that is 0, and 0 multiply by this function, that is the 0, and minus 2 e raised to minus s by s q. So here reason is what? E raised to minus infinity equal to 0 for upper limit case. This equal to 0 and minus multiply by inside the bracket, that become plus. So plus 2 e raised to minus s by s q, and this is the simply 2 into e raised to minus s by s q, and which is your required Laplace transform of the given function. Now come to the next example, example number 3. Find the Laplace transform of the function f of t, where f of t equal to cos t for t running from 0 to 2 pi, and f of t equal to 0 for t is greater than 2 pi. Solution. Using definition of Laplace transform, what is the definition of Laplace transform? Laplace transform of function f of t equal to integration of limit 0 to infinity e raised to minus st f of t dt. So we break this integral into two parts. Why? Because we have the function f of t equal to cos t for t running from 0 to 2 pi and f of t equal to 0 for t is greater than 2 pi. So we apply this function into the definition. So we will have integration of limit 0 to 2 pi e raised to minus st, instead of f of t we put in cos t because we have the limit 0 to 2 pi. So plus second term, integration of limit 2 pi to infinity e raised to minus st, and the second function is 0 dt. This equal to integration of limit 0 to 2 pi e raised to minus st into cos t dt plus 0, because anything multiplied by 0 is 0. And this equal to integration of limit 0 to 2 pi e raised to minus st cos t dt. Now see this. This is the standard integration. We have direct formula to evaluate this type of integral. So first one, if function is cos t, if function is cos t, then we have the formula integration of the function e raised to ax into cos bx dx equal to 1 upon a square plus b square into e raised to ax into a cos bx plus b sin bx. And if your function have the sine function, then the second integration become integration of the function e raised to ax into sin bx dx equal to 1 upon a square plus b square e raised to ax into a sin bx minus b cos bx. If your function is sine, then we will apply this formula, and if your function has cos, then we will apply this formula. Okay. Now apply formula number 1. Therefore, Laplace transform of f of t equal to 1 upon s square plus a square. Here a is minus s and b is coefficient of cos t, that is 1. So we will have Laplace transform of this integral equal to 1 upon s square plus 1 square into e raised to minus s t minus s cos t plus 1 sin t, and provide the limit 0 to 2 pi, because here integration of limit is 0 to 2 pi. Now apply the limit 1, this is equal to 1 upon s square plus 1 into upper limit e raised to minus 2 pi s, instead of t we put in 2 pi in bracket minus s, so instead of t we put in 2 pi, so minus s into cos 2 pi and plus sin 2 pi, instead of t we put in 2 pi, minus lower limit, lower limit is 0, so e raised to minus 0, here t, e exponential function become e raised to minus 0 into minus s and into cos 0 plus sin 0, and simplify this, so we will have this equal to 1 upon s square into e raised to minus 2 pi s in bracket minus s 1, because cos 2 pi is 1 and plus sin 2 pi is 0, and plus second term minus multiply by inside the bracket, that will be plus, so plus cos 0 is 1, so s into 1 and sin 0 is 0, and this equal to 1 upon s square plus 1 into e raised to minus 2 pi s into minus s plus s. So s is the common in the both the term, so we are taking s as a outside, so this equal to s by s square plus 1 into minus e raised to minus 2 pi s plus 1, because s is come outside, so this equal to s upon s square plus 1 into 1 minus e raised to minus 2 pi s. So this is the Laplace transform of given function. Thank you.